Hello. Today, within the Metropolitan discipline, these Inception lectures, we are going to deal with the physical component of the Metropolitan genome. This is the component that runs the physical environment, both natural and urban, of the metropolis. And that is going to be the opening door to the next phases of Metropolitan planning, investments, infrastructure, housing, and so on, which runs generally the decision-making of the structure of the metropolis. So this is really, out of the four components of the genoma, the one that opens the door to the physical planning and to the investments in the metropolis, and that's why it is the fourth one out of this series. In that component, we have mainly two sets of systems. We have the continuous systems and the discontinuous systems. The continuous systems are those that have to be together to work. For instance, in the continuous systems, we have the natural environment and the transports. You cannot have a kilometer of train, nothing, and a kilometer of train. The train has to go through, no? And when you arrive to the station, you have to be able to get down of the train and get into a bus or a BRT or any other means of transport. So really it has to be a continuous system where contiguity is necessary. The environment as well. You cannot have a park separated from another park. You must have biodiversity. And the flow of that biodiversity requires that the parks, the system from national parks to urban parks have to be as continuous as possible. No? In the other hand, we have the discontinuous systems, which is housing, productive activities, and social facilities. Housing is a system. Depending on where you put some houses, is going to affect the pattern of transport, is going to affect the pattern of distribution of goods, is going to affect the flows of elements, and is going to affect the other housing wherever in the metropolis. The income level of that housing is going to affect many other aspects. No? So housing is a system. Hospitals is a system, depending on your cancer hospital or maternity hospital, whatever, is a system, and they are all related together, and they are setting in space. But they don't need to be together. They don't need to be one next to the other. So they are discontinuous systems. So we have two continuous systems, which are environment and transport, and we have three discontinuous systems, which are housing, productive activities, industries, commerce, and offices, and social facilities. The more difficult ones, the ones by which you have to start planning and thinking about the metropolis, are the continuous ones. Because obviously when you have a continuous system imposed over territory with another continuous system, they are going to conflict. They are going to break that continuity, and you have to handle that in some ways, no? To avoid these conflicts or to minimize the effect of those conflicts. Once you have this environment mechanism that you have to start from it, the environment mechanism and then the transport together, the other three systems, which are housing, productive activities, and social facilities, as much easier to implement because you have more flexibility. Not being continuous, you have the possibility to move from one to the other a bit in the territory. So when you start a metropolis, you start building up the continuous systems. Environment is the base of it all because it gives you the topography, the structure of the metropolis. And then you build on that environment protection, not only protect environment, as well enhance the environment that might have been disrupted by previous actions. No, it's really and creating the continuous system of the environment. And then you built up the transport system, they're trying not to affect the environment. And if you affect the environment, you compensate that. There are compensation measures, and the Germans are very good at that kind of compensation approach. And then once you have the structure of the metropolis, you introduce the housing, the industry, commerce, and so on, and the hospitals, the schools, universities, and all the social facilities. So we have that. We have two ways of dealing with planning a metropolis, the physical component. One is the strategic approach of planning, and the other is the structural approach. No? The strategic deals with the four components of the genoma, and you have to articulate them. And you have two ways of articulating them. Either by words, you get together all the people that know most about the metropolis, and you have a process of agreements and discussions, or by figures. You have a technical approach of quantification of the elements and the formulas that interact among them, and you end up having a strategic plan about those components. And you have then the structural, which is already the physical approach to how you manage the metropolis. The strategic is more the elements of the genoma. And the structural is focusing on the physical, no? And then you must be aware that in a metropolis, the structural component has some basic rules and elements that we will see in another of the presentations. And you have then going down into the different municipal units, the regulatory framework for the land that has to be done at that municipal level. We have then the genoma. We know where we are in the genoma, how the physical component can help to balance the economic and the social, and how this is the basis, the map, the roadmap to build up a sound metropolis. And we must be aware in every moment that, as we saw in one of the previous presentations, that whatever you do in one of the segments, in one of the components, in one of the elements, is going to affect the others. We saw how an increase of education will make more efficient the economy. A more efficient economy will be able to pay higher taxes. Higher taxes will be able to provide social facilities in the physical environment, more universities, more schools, and so on, and how that will improve the capacity of the education of the population. And then the circular economy, now is a word very much in fashion, but in this case is used in another context. The circular economy has the implications of the decision of the decision maker of the metropolis all around, even if it's just from the physical component. Thank you very much. Next time we will see the different scales and the divergences in the way you must approach the management of the metropolis. You can download these slides for the link which is in the slide. Thank you very much.